on the tracker. If I draw a straight line from myself to Xinlei,
he's running along the Yardang.
He's on a mission at the moment. He's focused, he's goal-driven, he wants to win this for China. Ed's gone round the corner, but he's been funneled slightly to the right. Ed has followed the natural movement of Yardang. He doesn't want to go over this fortress.
It's not just the heat that is drying me out and dehydrating me, it's the wind as well. If I don't drink soon, I'm going to have a very, very miserable night. The water just there, through across the plain, are the mountains that I'm after. They don't look far away, do they? But distances are utterly deceptive around here. Next to me is a vast canyon. There's quite a bit of shade. If I use the canyon as my axis of travel, I could actually be walking in the shade for quite a lot of today. The shadow is being cast over the whole of the bottom of this valley. Look at that. That is extraordinary. And it feels cooler down here. It feels, the air almost feels fresh. The difference in the temperature when you come out into the direct sunlight is extraordinary. This little chap here, he's not terribly big, is he? But that's creamy. And there's another one. They are moist inside. Having had no water, that is a pleasant pop in the mouth. I'm taking far too long just to get across this short area of desert to the mountains. And it's not even in the direction of travel that's taking me towards the glacier.
The sun is intense. I'd be silly to push myself too much further today. Better to stay here and make a big push when it's cooler in the morning.
It's all beginning to be a little bit frustrating. My ultimate priority at the moment is fire. Nighttime, temperatures are dropping down to about zero. Okay, I had a little plan. And then you look at the bottom of my water bottle, there is a big curve on it. If I was to shine that up, I reckon that that is a nice parabola shape that I could actually use to start a fire with. These clumps of sediment are actually made from such fine lumps of powder that this is actually just abrasive enough just to polish the metal up, make it as much like a mirror as I can, and I can get a dry clump of grass and get it smouldering and hopefully turn it into fire. Heat stroke in the day, fears of that turn into actually fears of hypothermia. Fingers crossed this should work. And then I won't have any problems.
我看到了德爷的应该是德爷的脚印顺着沙漠往下走。他在下面。而我要在这里利用我的侦察兵的惯用手段 看看他到底想干什么。
It's interesting, on the tracker, it looks like the two of them are very, very close.
他拿了一个闪闪发光的东西，那是什么？ 啊，好聪明啊，德爷，是他的水壶。他用他的水壶底部的凹面来聚集太阳光点火。那他现在
既然在这里点火，就说明他要打庇护所在这里了。艾德现在正在扎营，所以说这是我争取时间赢了他的好机会。It's
smoking, but that is properly starting to go. Okay, there's a little bit of that's fire. That is a fire. That is a bonus. That this evening is not going to be as cold as I'd expected.
On the tracker, Ed had been heading west, but has now come to a complete stop. Xinlei, on the other hand, is making a bolt for it towards the sand dunes.
I find in situations like this, comfort doesn't really play a part. I don't think about the sort of niceties of life. Have I got fire? Is it going to rain? Real basics. And if all of those things add up, then I'm fine.
Today, I've been walking for a whole night. I think now it's 3 o'clock. It's definitely ahead of De Ye a big road. 这里有个可以避风的地方，可以在这里稍微休息一下，一直睡到明天早上太阳升起来的时候。我们以前当兵的时候，今天晚上走到极限，然后3、4点钟的时候开始睡觉，2个小时，然后等到天蒙蒙亮太阳没有升起来的时候再去挪一个比较安全的地方。其实我现在所用的地图，跟原来当兵的时候是一个样子的。
昨天晚上睡了大概3个小时吧，我觉得我越来越缺水了，所以我要趁着太阳还没有升起来的时候，再走上几公里。
At the moment, Xinlei has definitely made ground. He's moved through the night, so he's in the lead without a doubt. Ed looks like he's headed towards the Black Mountains. The smartest move before you move across the plains is to consolidate. If you can find food and you can find water, then you've got a chance to cross it. If you don't, then this will beat you up.
I am so thirsty now. My head is pounding. These here are the foothills of the Black Mountains. If there is any water, this is where it should be. Water is around the next corner. It has to be. It absolutely has to be. Bone dry. Okay. Come on, Stafford, don't give up now. Everything's dry. Everything is bone dry. If that was moist, I'd think it was worth my while digging, but it's not even remotely moist. I don't even care about the race anymore. This is now a survival situation in terms of finding water. Ahead of me now, it's sandy dunes again. I'm pretty much through all of the basalt, through the Black Mountain, and I've not seen any indicators of water, none at all.
Ed left the Black Rock Mountains. There's no water there. I've scouted all around. There is no water there. He has to keep going southwest, and that's the only way he will find a water source. Xinlei's taken the shortest route over the dunes. However, these dunes are absolutely massive here. That's the problem. You imagine being on a stairmaster in a gym for 24 hours, and that is what he's doing.